This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way. This week, NASA's released an awesome close-up image of Ceres, the body the Dawn spacecraft is on its way to visit. But what exactly is Ceres? Hey guys, Amy here on DNews. If you aren't sure what exactly Ceres is, you are definitely not alone. Ceres is a dwarf planet that scientists also refer to as an embryonic planet. When the planets in our solar system formed from the swirling cloud of gas and dust, Ceres wanted to be a planet too, but Jupiter had other ideas. The gas giant is just so massive that its gravitational pull was enough to stop Ceres from accumulating enough material to become a fully-fledged planet in its own right. Instead, it joined all the other leftover debris that makes up the asteroid belt. But Ceres wasn't always considered an embryonic planet, because it wasn't always obviously one of thousands of bodies in the asteroid belt. Ceres was discovered in 1801 by Sicilian astronomer Father Giuseppe Piazzi. This small body between Mars's and Jupiter's orbit solved a major astronomical quandary. Why was there no planet in an orbit where astronomers predicted there should be one? Now there was one. Piazzi named it Ceres after the Roman goddess of corn and harvest, and it was entered into textbooks, which were admittedly few in the early 1800s. But as more objects were found in the vicinity of Ceres, Vesta, Juno, and Pallas, that first body became less unique and special. Taken together, these small bodies were collectively called asteroids or minor planets, but they were still considered planets. They even had symbols like the major planets do. But as more and more small bodies were found, the scene became a little too crowded. In the 1850s, American astronomer B.A. Gould suggested doing away with the small body symbols and replacing them with a new standard shorthand notation, a circle with a number inside, the number correlating to the order in which the bodies were discovered. This system was really simple and was adopted pretty quickly. Ceres' designation varied between publications in the mid-1800s, called a little planet, an asteroid, a planet, and sometimes multiple names at once. By the 1860s, Ceres was folded into the group of bodies that lies between Mars and Jupiter, all of which were called asteroids, until 2006, when Ceres' planet-like qualities earned it a reclassification as a dwarf planet alongside Pluto. But like Pluto, Ceres being a dwarf planet doesn't make it any less incredible. It's about 590 miles across, which is large enough that it makes up 25% of the mass in the asteroid belt, but it's still 14 times less massive than Pluto. And there are signs that Ceres contains large amounts of ice beneath its surface and water vapor perhaps rooted in sublimating ice. If Ceres turns out to be just 25% water, it will have more fresh water than the Earth. NASA's Dawn spacecraft is going into orbit around the dwarf planet on March 6th of this year, so we'll have some pretty good answers soon. Are you excited to see what we're going to learn about this little planet turned asteroid turned dwarf planet? Let us know in the comments below, or you can catch me on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe right here for more DNews every day of the week. This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.